All right, we're on the draw yet again for round three. I think this hand is a keeper. Just turn one Glade Cover Scout with something to put on it is really good. Hopefully it works out for us. If we draw like another aura, we should be in really, really good shape. Looks like our opponent is another red-based aggressive deck. I don't know if they're, you know, going to the face with Magma Jet on turn two, but we'll see. Looks like he's a red devotion deck, and we have drawn terribly. So yeah, like Armadillo Cloak, or I guess Armadillo Cloak wouldn't actually be that good. You can probably just double block, but Gift of Orzhova or the other one would be insane. How about a land instead? At least he can't really attack that well. So he probably has another creature to play. If we draw a gift, yeah, we should be in really good shape if we draw a gift. Hey, there it is. I mean, he still has a pretty sizable force to swing back with, but we have a nice Baneslayer Angel assembled at this point. Oh my. Well, there's a good chance we're going to take a lot of damage this turn from a dragon or something like that. No. Going even deeper on the mana. So if he plays Purphoros, he could pump his team twice. Apparently not. Is his last card even good? No. Okay, well, we're in good shape then. We're going to take 10 down to 7 here and then go back up to 12. I guess we have to draw something because he has enough, like it's 8, 14, 15, 16 power. So that blocks 4 of it. So we take 3, 6, 8, 12, which is exactly what we would be at if we attacked. However, if we don't attack, how do we win? We have to like trade off our Glade Cover Scout, which seems horrible. Like we block both the Frostburn Weirds. I think we just have to. I don't like this spot. Witchstalker could block there, and we block there, and then we take 10 and go to 2. And have a Witchstalker left over. I don't really like that. Yeah, I think we just have to attack and hope he makes a mistake. I don't think we're going to win this game by hanging back. Like, obviously we leave ourselves dead on board, but I don't see any other way to win this game than other than hoping that he makes a mistake. Looks like he is not going to make a mistake. Basically, you could argue that we leave ourselves dead on board by doing this, but I can't think of a combination of cards we could draw that actually get us out of the situation if we don't do this. So I'm willing to go in on it. All right. We weren't even drawing the pump spell to make it lethal anyway. So Fiendslayer Paladin definitely comes in here. I think Holy Mantle is probably good. Boonsader is not going to be good. Skylasher is not going to be good. And the last cut could be Voice of Resurgence, maybe. I don't really want to go that low on creatures, though. Maybe we'll just leave. We'll only bring in one Holy Mantle. They're kind of expensive. Chain to the Rocks also might be okay against him. He's going to have... probably going to have Storm Breath Dragon, which we can't target, but Boros Reckoner is a reasonable target.